Welcome back to Ana Dialogue, the dialogue on analog music reproduction. In this episode, we're going to take a look at the main aspects, the main characteristics that you need to look for and also you need to avoid in order to purchase, to buy, or to make the perfect power strip. Are you ready? Let's go. Okay guys, we're gonna go through 8 main points in order to determine what you need to look out for in order to obtain the best type of power strip for your hi-fi system. I know a lot of you don't believe in quality power, but trust me, it does make a change. Try. Why not trying? Already with a good power strip, you will notice incredible benefits. Okay, so number one, let's start. Chassis. You need to look for, the optimum would be an aluminum type of chassis. Versus avoid a plastic type if you can. Because aluminum, not only it makes the power strip more sturdy and durable through time, but it also isolates the power, the different outlets from RFI, EMI, interference in general. So it's always a good idea to try to use this type of external box. Okay guys, let's proceed. Point number two, wiring. Now this is one of the most important of all, because if you find something that is created with the following type of wiring, you're probably looking at an audiophile grade product. What am I talking about? I'm talking about star wiring versus serial wiring. It's always a good idea to try to have the different outlets, the different plugs in a power strip with independent wiring. I mean, which means for the phase, for the neutral and the ground, each one has to have its own wire and must not be connected to the outlet next to it, but directly to the wire, the power wire itself, or the IEC inlet if you have one on the power strip. But we will see that is not a wise solution. Well, it's not optimal, we could say. In any case, star wiring, it's just better, because otherwise each outlet is connected one to another, and if you have some problems in one, it's gonna go and pollute all the other outlets. So other types of interference, hums, overall the quality is just gonna lower. So if you have each one independently connected, star wiring, that's the top choice. Let's proceed. Okay, point number three, wire. The wire itself has to be, should be of high quality if possible. A good idea is also to get a quality power strip and replace the cables inside, the wires inside, with what? Possibly OFC, or even better, you know it, OCC copper, or even silver if you want. Avoid instead the brass, those brass bars, which is connected to the concept of star wiring we said before. Avoid those bars, which usually are brass, so the very poor quality, very poor conductivity, which connect all the outlets. No. We want independent wiring and high quality wiring, if possible. And as I said, you can replace it if you want. Let's proceed. Point number four, clamps. Now this is a little more difficult. Rarely you're gonna find quality clamps inside a power strip. This is mainly aimed when you're doing your own power strips. Why? Because usually, commonly, you're gonna find brass clamps. What are clamps? It's the little outlets or different parts for, or the EAC inlet. If you have one that is using a clamp to grab on the wire in order to have the connection, the electrical connection. It's better if you have quality clamps. Gold plated, that's already excellent, but if you can, even OCC or FC copper, but it's very rare to find those. I know that, so don't worry. If you can, try to go to this higher quality type. If you don't worry, but it's good to know. Let's proceed. Point number five, polarity. Now this regards mainly EU types of connections, wires, power outlets, inlets, etc. Because, for example, the UK or the US types don't have this problem. You already know which is the hot one, which is the cold one. Instead, for example, in Europe, you don't know that because the cable, the plug, is reversible, and that is not good. Obviously, you need to know the polarity also of the cable. And I explained once in a video how to know that. Take a look. Here's a link. At the same time, you need to know the polarity. Where is the phase on the power strip itself? You can do it also by yourself. No problems with that. But if it's already indicated, usually with a red dot or something, again, you can do it by your own, it's better. In order to have the perfect combination, the perfect phase with your cable and your equipment. Let's proceed. Point number 6, cable. What do I mean? I mean the piece of cable coming out of your power strip that is going to get its power from the wall socket or another power strip or a power conditioner or whatever it is. Now, a lot of people tend to think that an IEC inlet is better because you can choose your cable, your quality audiophile cable, which it is true, but you're adding two more contacts along the line, which isn't that good. The best solution, that's what we're looking for, is to have a cable directly connected to all the outlets, so there is continuity, but quality types of wires in the cable itself, and also the connector, also the plug itself has to be of high quality, possibly gold-plated, while the cable itself should be, you know it, OCC copper. That's the best of the best. Otherwise, also OFC, no problem. But please do pay attention, because otherwise it doesn't matter if you have quality outlets if then you're using a very bad quality cable. It has to be homogeneous in this sense. Let's proceed. Point number 7, design. The power strip needs to be a power strip. It doesn't have to have other things like switches on and off, like fuses. No, guys, it'll kill dynamics. It'll just impoverish the sound. If there are other things in the middle of the connection, just keep it simple. That's the best solution. Let's proceed. Point number 8, contacts. Now, again, this regards mainly those using EU plugs, European plugs, or other places in the world that are not using standard types of plugs. In fact, it's better to have, the optimum is, large types of contacts, 16 amperes against 10 amperes, which is the smaller connections. That's what we use in Italy usually. It's better to get the larger plugs, or the Schuko, the German type, with those two fat plugs. It's just better. It's better if you have more contact, and the electricity will just travel better. That's the best of the best. Let's proceed. Okay, we've reached the end of these 8 important parts. I also will do a video in the future trying to suggest, first of all, how to make your own, but also some specific suggestions for what's out there. Because if you go and get a quality power strip, a so-called audiophile quality power strip, unfortunately, they're going to ask you $300, $400, $500 euro for that stuff. And you do not need to spend so much. I want to mention, though, one example, which is very renowned among audiophiles. The Wire World Matrix 2. I have it here plugged in my system. Here's an image. I don't want to unplug everything. That's why I'm showing you an image. It's a good power strip, okay? Because it has a decent price. It's not cheap, obviously, because it is a quality type of power strip. It is using OFC copper, not OCC, but it's okay. It doesn't have its own cable. You're gonna have to purchase also cable, and that's adding more money to the whole component. But what's the problem here that you have to pay attention? It's not a true star connection, or at least not all the outlets. Because if you see the image, you can see the outlets are in pairs. Why is that? Because they're connected. Two are connected to the source. So not all are independent, but in couples, they are connected to the power cable, the final IEC inlet. So one is gonna be good, one is gonna be so-so. And you need to know that since you're spending that much money. So I do not recommend actually using the Wire World, even though I do have it. But there are other solutions. The best, I think, is to try to do your own. Another important aspect that I think you need to keep in mind is that you should have, the best solution would have, a great, good quality power conditioner. And at that point, you're going to use your quality power strip from that. Start from the normal power socket in the wall, but if you can, try to invest in a good quality power conditioner. As you know, that was my first video, and I deeply believe in that. The quality of the audio of your system, especially your amplifier, power amplifier, and things like that, are going to greatly benefit from all of this. Try and let me know. Thank you guys for watching, and remember, music is born analog. Well guys, if you're enjoying my videos and you're enjoying my channel, please consider to subscribe by clicking the black and white logo here below. Also, don't forget to click the notification bell so you'll never miss an episode and you will become a true member of the analog community.